Hello, and welcome to this video on creating hierarchy diagrams. As with many data visualizations, there are plenty of software options available to create these in, but today we're going to look and see how to create one in Microsoft PowerPoint. Before we get into making one though, let's have a glance at what we are looking to make. This is just a very basic outline with a lot of potential applications. They can get more complicated, and they can be more vertical than this horizontal one, but this is just a basic structure. I've just used letters here, but let's say we're talking about a business chain. A could be the headquarters, B could show the regional offices that report to the headquarters, and C could be the branch locations that report to the regional offices. All right, now that we have a basic picture of what we want, let's make one in Microsoft PowerPoint.
Okay, so we have a blank PowerPoint presentation open, and we're going to go ahead and go to the Insert tab to start. And then under Illustrations, we have a Smart Art button, and that's what we're going to click on. There's a lot of different options in here, but we're doing hierarchies today, and they actually have a category just for this. We're going to click on this one, and we can see that they've got a couple of different layouts, but we're just going to do Organizational Chart. Go ahead and click OK, and it's got a basic little skeleton in here for us. And this little box over here at the side, you can hide this if you want to. We're going to work with it in just a minute. I'll close it so that you can see what it looks like when it's gone away, and you can pop it out again with this little arrow here at the side. Okay, so we can go ahead and start editing it now. We're going to use our example from before with the headquarters for the business, the regional offices, and the branch locations. So we can click here at the bullet points in the side, or we can edit the text in here. I kind of prefer to do the bullet points because it gives you a little bit more control and you can kind of see what you're doing a little easier. So in this basic skeleton that it's given us, we can see that this box right here kind of pops off from the side, and that's indicated by the soft return, which is this teeny tiny little arrow right here. If you're not familiar with soft returns, that's when you press and hold shift and enter. So it kind of gives you a new line, but it's treated a little differently as well. And that's not what we're looking for. So we'll go ahead and backspace it. And you can see that the chart updates as we do that. We'll just backspace again. And now it's gone away. So we've got the one thing at the top, the headquarters. And then we've got these other three, which are branching down from that. So we'll do the regional offices. And then if we do enter again to get another bullet point, that puts it all on the same level, and we want to actually indent it in, so we'll press tab, and then we'll do the branch location. Okay, so we're going to do that for each of these. I've typed it out already so that you don't have to watch me type. Okay, so I'm going to do a control all and paste it in there, and there we've got a pretty nice skeleton now for our headquarters in Chicago. Got the regional offices in Los Angeles, Denver, and New York, and then several branch locations for each regional office. So let's close this little box at the side since we're kind of done entering in our information. And let's have a look at some of the formatting options. So we've still got the diagram highlighted. So we've got the design tab and the format tab under the Smart Art tools. And if you click away, then you'll see that both of those tabs go away. So you just have to make sure that it's highlighted before you can get those options again. And under the design tab, we can do a couple of things. We can change the colors. So it just defaulted into blue, but we can change it into several of the other accent colors. And you can also do multicolor as well, which is kind of fun. We'll maybe try this one here. All right, and we've got some other options here for the style as well. You can play around with these and see what kind of thing works best for your project. We'll leave it as it is. Okay, so the format tab has some other options on here that you can play around with. You can really customize this so you can change the text and things like that. You can also simply change the text as you normally would through the home tab and change the font and the size and things like that, or italics if you want that.
Okay, so that wraps up this video. We've covered the basics on creating a hierarchy diagram in Microsoft PowerPoint. The version of PowerPoint you're using might mean that some of the features I showed are in different places or aren't available, and you might actually have more features that you didn't see on my screen. Hopefully, things should be roughly the same though. The Microsoft support website is really useful for learning how to do things, but please also reach out to the library if you have questions. Thanks for watching!